Wait. Something's happening.
Cheers, bitches. What's up? It's Marty again. Chef Marty. We're drinking, apparently. And we're going to talk about some food today. I don't normally have a cocktail when I'm cooking, but they told me, what would you drink with this dish? So I went ahead and ordered a margarita. So that leads us into what we're cooking. This is the special that we're currently serving at the restaurant. It is called the Spicy Shrimp Scampi. Seems pretty straightforward. I've always liked scampi. It's a classic Italian pasta dish. But I also, many years ago, discovered a Mexican dish which is similar. And it's on a lot of Mexican restaurant menus, called camarones al mojo de ajo, which means shrimp with this really slow cooked garlic that has lime juice added to it. Super, super yummy, the slow cooking of the garlic calms down that raw garlic aggressiveness and turns it into this sweet, really silky yumminess that the lime juice kind of brightens and you add some salt in there. Really delicious stuff. So I decided to create a mashup of those two dishes. And that's how we end up with my spicy shrimp scampi. So we're gonna go ahead and cook it. I've got my pan hot here. I wanna show you that garlic I was talking about. This started out as cloves of fresh garlic. And you put those in a pan and you submerge them in oil. I use a blended olive oil and then real olive oil, about 50-50. And you bring that slowly up to heat. You're not deep frying them. If you bring it to a high heat, it's gonna end up deep frying these cloves of garlic till they're crispy, crunchy brown, not what you want. But on a real low heat, that oil heats up and starts to bubble. And after about 45 minutes to an hour, all that garlic turns this golden brown color. It all becomes silky soft. And add a little bit of lime juice, a little bit of salt in there. Finish cooking it, drain off the oil, and then just take a fork and mash it all up. And that is what it turns into. It is this delicious, sweet, just caramelized garlic deliciousness. I can't describe it any other way. But anyway, that is one of the main ingredients in this dish. Okay, let's get started. This is the oil that I drained off of those garlic cloves. I use it to cook this dish with, so we're bringing that flavor back, magnifying it. Boil into a hot pan. We start out with a little bit of julienne shallots. Shallots are a form of onion, a smaller, more French form of onion. They're not as aggressive tasting, little smaller slices, a little easier to eat. Just a little bit of salt on there. Also gives you just a little bit of texture in the finished product. You don't want to cook them too long, but you do want them to have a little bit of bite to them. So. Okay, the shallots are cooking. Very quickly, after that, I will add the shrimp. We're using shrimp are graded by size. Generally the number refers to how many of them it takes to make up a pound. These are 21 to 25, so it takes that many to equal a pound. We're serving 6 in this entree. I'll go ahead and pop those in there. And these are U.S. Gulf shrimp, from the Gulf, not from far away in the island. So those are in there. I always like to wear gloves when I'm handling shrimp, especially because there are a lot of people that have some severe allergies to shellfish and shrimp, especially. And so I always want to be real careful about that. Okay, those are cooking. Turn that heat up a little bit. How do you know when a shrimp is cooked? It turns pink. Very straightforward. And they don't take long to cook. Nothing worse than an overcooked shrimp. It's super rubbery. Flop those over. Now we're going to add some more ingredients. We're going to add that garlic, a healthy spoonful of that. Like I said, this is the heart of the dish. And then we've got our Mexican element. I like, I always say I like my food spicy. I like it to bite back. So I've got these are chipotle peppers. They come in a can in chipotles in adobo sauce, and I am I have all my pasta warmed up. I have ground those all up, blended those all up together into a puree. So I'm just going to go ahead and add some of that. Like it spicy, add more. Otherwise, it just kind of provides a smoky, slightly spicy backbone to the dish. Go ahead and mix that up. See what we're doing here is we're starting to create our sauce. Huge flavors in that sauce. And those shrimp are just swinging in it. All right. Now, a little more liquid elements here. We've got some fresh lime juice. Just a little for some acid and some brightness. Also a little white wine, about an equal amount. And then to kind of stretch that sauce and calm down some of those flavors, we put in a little vegetable stock. There, the makings of our sauce. More salt, more pepper. And here we have our linguine, which has been warmed up really quick in boiling water. This was already cooked, and then we just dunk it in the hot water to heat it through. That goes in the dish. Give that a nice toss. We have a little bit of a fresh herb blend here. I take parsley and cilantro, chop those up together, and dry them out just a little bit so that they are they're easy to handle that way. If they're fresh, if we didn't dry them out, they would stick to your hand and never get that into the pan. So, just a little spoon or pinch of that in there. And I think just about there. I'm going to taste that really quick. Perfect. Alright. We're done. See how fast that was? Much faster than last week's risotto. So, anybody make that risotto? I'd love to hear about it. So we're going to plate this real quick. When you plate pasta in a restaurant, these long noodles, you leave the shrimp behind, twirl that pasta, pick it up, put it right in the center, and twirl it to try and get a little more height on your presentation instead of just having it all kind of go splat. Take those shrimp, which are beautiful. They show really well on a plate. Just want to put those around the edge. Mix them all the same way. Isn't that party? All right. A couple last items here. A little more of the herb. Little green. Shaved parmesan cheese we put right on top. It's a nice counterpoint to the spice, kind of calms it down. And then garnish it with a lime wedge. And we do a slice of Breadfarm's white bread. We grill a little bit of clarified butter in there. Alright, there you have it. Doesn't it look good? Spicy shrimp scampi with chipotle and caramelized garlic. Come on and get it! It's going fast. Bye, guys.